At this time, we ask that you please take your seats. Also, please silence all cell phones for the duration of the ceremony. Our ceremony will begin in a few minutes. Thank you.
To purchase a brick so that we had something to show our connection forever.
I think it's a great way to memorialize your time as a Capital student and a great way to support the university as an alumni.
I went online and ordered a brick to be placed on the plaza in his memory.
Ross and I met at Capital as student ambassadors. We were friends all through Capital, and then after Capital, I invited him as my date to an event that I was the event planner for. He was very impressed because he sent me flowers afterwards. From then on, we started dating, and now we've been married for 3 years, and we just had our first baby, Hildy, and she is 3 months old. All of our beginnings and now our current life are all connected to Capital, and we truly love this community, and it's still such a special place to us.
When I look back on my time at Capital, I think some of my favorite memories are when I was in my fraternity, Phi Kappa Psi, and on my brick I have my Greek letters because the community of FSL at Capital was so important to me. Most of my best friends and greatest mentors came from the Greek community at Capital.
My husband, Nicholas Perini, was a professor at Capital. He started in 1958, stepped down in 2011, so he was at Capital for 53 years, which, to my knowledge, is perhaps the longest of anyone that has been at Capital. He loved Capital. He loved teaching. When he gave lessons at home, I was around the corner and heard, and it always amazed me what he knew to bring out of his students. But when Nick passed away a couple years ago, I wanted to honor his memory in some way because there were so many students that loved him. And I also thought his 53 years deserved some recognition. I think it's just a wonderful way to commemorate so many wonderful things that have happened at Capital through the years.
I think that's a really important part of being an active alumni, is staying engaged, whether it be donating funds or time. There's always an opportunity to give back to your alma mater.
We get to roll our daughter in the stroller past a brick that we purchased at the university where we first met and where Ross asked me to spend the rest of my life with him. So it's something that is literally a foundation in our relationship and our lives. So it's the beginning of telling Hildy exactly how we met and reminding her of that every time we're on campus.
Thank you. Thank you.
family and friends, welcome to the 173rd Commencement of Capital University. Please rise for the presentation of the American flag by the ROTC Color Guard. Please be seated for the processional.
Thank you.
The invocation will be given by the Reverend Dykea Ellery, Associate Director of Religious and Spiritual Life. Please stand for the invocation and remain standing for the national anthem.
Let us pray. Gracious Creator, it is our privilege to invite you here as the guest of honor on this occasion. We thank you for your presence here with us and ask that you would bless this graduating class. Oh God, you are the creator of the human mind, and you have blessed us with various abilities to learn. Thank you for the precious gifts of knowledge and discovery. I ask on behalf of those gathered here that you would indeed bless each of these graduates. Give them the grace to make a difference for the good wherever they may find themselves in the years ahead. For those who will pursue further education, grant not only the knowledge they will need in their chosen fields, but also wisdom to apply that knowledge to life as it really is. For those who will be going directly into the workforce, give them wisdom and grace as they navigate the often confusing issues they will face. For those in military service, may they draw courage and strength from you. May they serve with integrity and honor. For all these graduates and the families of which they are a part of, we ask that they may make a significant contribution to the general welfare of society. May they especially be a blessing to those whose lives they personally touch. And now may all that is said and done in this space on this day give glory and honor to your holy name. And it is in your name that I pray. Amen.
Please be seated. Members of the Capital University Chapel Choir, led by Dr. Linda Hassler, will now perform two selections. The first selection is I Sing Because I Am Happy. The second is a Chapel Choir traditional selection. The Lord bless you and keep you.
Hello, soon to be college graduates of the class of 2023. And hundreds of your biggest fans. First, we want you to know that the Chapel Choir and I also consider ourselves part of your fan club. We love having the opportunity every year to sing in celebration of such a huge accomplishment of becoming a college graduate. Now, this year there's a twist. We're going to ask all of you to help us celebrate you. We'll be singing a piece called I Sing Because I'm Happy, and we do because we are. It's a gospel setting of the hymn, His Eye is on the Sparrow. Now, there's a place in this piece where the audience is invited to join in. The words are, I'm so happy, yes. I'm so happy, yes, I am. And I can only imagine that the parents and grandparents and loved ones in the room are feeling those words. Thank you. We're off to a very good beginning. So I'd like you to try the words with us a moment. Remember, I'm so happy, yes. I'm so happy, yes, I am. Here we go. I'm so happy, yes. I'm so happy, yes, I am. great. So there'll come a time where the soprano, alto, tenor, and bass will sing a simple line. And then they'll sing it a second time with you joining in. Choose a part. Choose all the parts. When it's all been sung once, then we all sing together for a bit. Feel free to stand. Feel free to clap. Feel free to keep switching parts. But whatever you do, please sing because you're happy.
I sing because I'm happy.
Dr. Hassler would like to invite any choir alumni in the audience to come forward now and join the choir for "The Lord Bless You and Keep You." Everyone, please welcome the 17th president of Capital University, David L. Kaufman.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome, class of 2023, to this special occasion. Any better than this? I'm Dave Kaufman, and it's an honor to have the opportunity to serve as president of Capital University and participate in this celebration. Let's give the orchestra and chapel choir another round of applause. Can we thank you, Dr. Hassler? Thank you. On behalf of our faculty and staff, I extend sincere congratulations to all of our students for achieving your degrees. Today, you take your well-deserved walk across the stage and receive official recognition for the graduation you worked so hard for. Yes. This ceremony not only celebrates a milestone in your personal and academic growth, it also marks the beginning of new paths and opportunities yet to come. I'd also like to welcome the family and friends joining us for this special day. We recognize and appreciate the impact each of you has made on the graduates we honor. Thank you for your support and encouragement. Thank you. Graduates, your Capital experience has been unlike any other. You endured unprecedented pandemic conditions, met academic challenges, grew as an individual, and engaged in your Capitol community. You've successfully completed this journey, but it is a journey, it's not a destination. I encourage you to keep an open mind and capitalize on new opportunities as they arise. Learn to appreciate that when one door shuts, another will open with new possibilities. I agree with John Maxwell, who said, change is inevitable, growth is optional, and you chose to grow. The university also chose to evolve and grow. Despite the unique conditions, a Capitol education remains distinctive for its commitment to excellence and its inspiration to live a life of reflection, leadership, and service. It's a place where students are accepted just as they are and become the best versions of themselves. As a university, we welcome free inquiry, model ethical stewardship, and champion access and affordability. As a Capitol graduate, you understand these commitments and help create this unique sense of community. Through interactions with others, your classmates, roommates, professors and staff, your Capitol education has transformed you. And through your personal engagement and contribution, you have forever transformed this university. Today we mark a new beginning and celebrate a milestone in your personal growth and achievement. Many of you will pursue your vocational calling. Others will continue academic pursuits in graduate school. Some of you will move far from Central Ohio to pursue global opportunities. Regardless of where life takes you tomorrow, today is a day to celebrate all you've achieved. Embrace it. As you move forward, take time to look back and reflect on the obstacles you overcame. Thank those who helped you overcome them, and just as importantly, find a way to pay them back by paying it forward and doing it for someone else. Forever a member of the Capitol family, you're encouraged to keep in touch as you progress through your career and life journey. The university is a trusted resource for your continued development, education, and guidance. Engage with us, share your story, and nurture the lifelong connections you made through your Capitol experience. We are here for you, always, in all ways. Let your life be shaped by the values and commitments you developed here. You've learned that more important than what you do is who you are and what you value. Continue to ask, think, and lead as you progress through your career. You leave here empowered to contribute to causes bigger than yourself and make a lasting difference where you live, work, learn, and serve. It's a blessing and an honor to join you in this celebration as you enter the next chapter of your life and explore all the opportunities that are going to come your way. We are proud of you and celebrate who you are and all you've achieved. Congratulations. And now I'd like to introduce our special guests behind me on stage. On my left is Dr. Sharon Croft, Professor of Communications, who will read the graduates' names. Reverend Dykia Ellery, who gave the invocation. Thank you, Dykia. Marty Taylor, Vice Chair of the Board of Trustees. Dr. Jody Fournier, Provost. Our guest speaker, Stephen Spotswood. Reverend Drew Tucker, University Pastor. And our faculty marshal, Dr. Steve Clymer. Please join me with a round of applause thanking them and all our faculty and staff. It's the classroom experience they deliver and the relationship they develop with each student that differentiates us as a university. Thank you. Today's commencement speaker walked across this stage in his cap and gown just a few short years ago. A Maryland native, Stephen Spotswood moved to Columbus specifically to study music education here at Capitol. Upon completing his undergraduate studies in 2016, Stephen began his solo career as a hip-hop and jazz violinist while working as a middle school orchestra teacher at Reynoldsburg City Schools. He inspired students and communities as the musical director of the Inner City Youth Orchestra, Urban Strings Columbus, from 2012 to 2016. In January of 20, Stephen founded the Columbus Cultural Orchestra, a collective of multi-generation musicians of color, and currently serves as its artistic director. Please join me in welcoming Stephen Spotwood, our 2023 commencement speaker.
Good morning, my name is Stephen Spotswood, and it is truly an honor to speak before you, to speak before Capital University's class of 2023. I'm a proud alumni of Capital University. The education I received here is without question a large reason why I'm a successful musician, educator, and entrepreneur today. I'd like to tell you a little bit about my journey. You see, I wasn't at the top of my class here. I wasn't the perfect A student. Matter of fact, on a couple occasions, I didn't even know if I was going to graduate. I was far away from home. I was one of the only handful of African-American musicians in my class. When I was a senior here, I struggled to pass what is called the Praxis exam. This exam is very important because in order to be a music teacher, you have to pass this exam so that you can teach grades K through 12 in the state of Ohio. I was so close. I had almost reached the mountaintop. I had passed all my classes and was ready to graduate, but this one portion of this exam, this math portion, I could not pass. If I couldn't pass this math exam, I wouldn't be able to graduate. I would not be able to land a teaching job. I wouldn't be able to work in the schools, and all throughout my schooling, all of this hard work I put in would go out the window. It took me 6 tries to pass the exam. Finally, I could move forward after 6 tries. But I want to go back in my story to maybe the 3rd or 4th time that I failed the test. It was around here that I had a breaking point. This is the moment where I felt doomed and hopeless. It was here where I had to sing. It was a turning point to me where I didn't care anymore, so I yelled out, "I won't give up. I won't be discouraged." My father directed the choir in church, and I remember growing up, he sang this gospel song. I sang this gospel song out loud, and I began to cry. I began to pray and ask God for his help. This is what we all struggle with, isn't it? It's inevitable that we fail tests, but what do we do if we don't pass? We will run into obstacles. Stress will get the best of us. Life will throw punches at our way. What do we do? You know what? During that 3rd or 4th time I failed that test, what if I just YOLO'd it? You only live life once. I could just follow my millennial bad habits and take the easy way out. Or what if I decided to follow my moral compass? I could change my stress and channel it in a positive way. I've YOLO'd it before. It never turned out good. See, our millennial generation, I believe we kind of have a serious problem where we want to take shortcuts. I'm sure everyone in here has seen an ad on YouTube or something that says, "I want to earn $1 million in a week. Do you? I can show you how. Just invest in Bitcoin. Follow me." Or, "Let me just overnight ship on my Amazon Prime account so I can get whatever I want, whenever I want." We want this instant gratification, whereas our parents' generation, they had to grab their lunch pails and work hard for everything they had. I heard an amen. We can't YOLO our way around life and expect to achieve our desired results at an optimum level. A test by design is structured to challenge us and pressure us to focus on a different outcome, on a desired outcome. We have to ask ourselves, why are we being tested? Well, anything worth fighting for, nobody's gonna hand it to you. You're gonna have to work for it. You can't Amazon Prime it overnight. If landing that firm job as an attorney was easy, everybody would do it. If raising $1 million for that educational startup company were easy, everybody would do it. If making the dean's list at graduation was easy, everybody would be on the list. If making millions of dollars to play in a professional sports league or symphony were easy, everybody would do it. When I went through my days at Capitol, most of the time I would YOLO it. And I had to learn the hard way that I'm not as big and bad as I thought I was. And that there is a moral compass that I should follow. And that my life is not meaningless. I couldn't just act however I wanted. My life has a purpose, and so does yours. That means that I couldn't hang out with everybody. I had to stop listening to certain music and participating in certain activities and being involved in certain relationships. My life has a purpose, and every day is a test to live life on purpose. So what's the solution? David in the Bible was being attacked by Saul on every angle. He was being chased by mighty soldiers day and night, hiding in caves, withstanding great oppression. But guess what he always reverted to in these dark times? His harp. And I say that with the musician in me. He would take out that harp and he would sing to God. He always kept his song near. And that is what I'm here to tell you all today. Always keep your song near. Have you ever been to an old school Baptist church, or do you have a grandmother or auntie who just used to hum all the time? They just, Grandma, why do you hum all the time? My grandmother always kept her song down on the inside of her. Singing your song is about remembering your story. I'm not talking about singing well or anything, or playing an instrument well. You could sound like a dying quail for all I'm concerned. What I'm talking about is that chamber deep down inside, that inner voice, that shimmer of light, that hope in something bigger than yourself. Singing your song says, this is who I am, this is where I come from, this is why I'm here, this is where I'm going. It could come out in a hum, it could come out in a shout, it could come out in a clapping of your hands, but it's the song of the champion inside of your soul. The song that says, I'm alive today, so I must have a purpose. I'm a winner. As long as there's breath in my lungs, I will live a life of purpose. You gotta tell yourself this sometimes. You may sound crazy, but who are you talking to? You gotta preach to yourself. I came from nothing, but I'm still here. All hell has broken loose in my life, but I'm still standing. I am somebody. When I was a student at Capital University, sometimes I didn't know my purpose and I strayed away from it. But I did remember when I did have a purpose, and it helped me to be the man I am today, to teach and be a role model for young African-American musicians in our underserved communities, to mix hip-hop and classical music, and to show them that there is a space for their heritage and their culture in an orchestra. Our song is the melody that illustrates our lives, that says, this is who I am, this is where I come from, this is why I'm here, and this is where I am headed. Always keep your song near you. That is what David did. So what will you do, graduating class, Capital University graduating class of 2023? Will you keep your song near you? I challenge you to sing your song today and moving forward. Remember your roots, where you come from. Take into account all that God has blessed you with and be grateful. Take inventory of your heritage, your family lineage, your gifts and talents, your ability to have character, integrity, perseverance, and the will to win. After all, you all did make it through the pandemic. Perseverance is in your DNA. Take captive all that God has blessed you with and sing a new melody. If we can all do that, ladies and gentlemen, I strongly believe that we will fulfill the prophecy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., who said, make a career of humanity, commit yourself to noble struggle for equal rights. You will make a better person of yourself, a greater nation of your country, and a finer world to live in. Congratulations.
Please welcome Marty Taylor, class of 1986, and vice chair of the Capital University Board of Trustees.
Thank you, and thank you, Stephen, for those words of inspiration. As Capital University Board of Trustees vice chair, it is my pleasure to now commission the awarding of degrees. I ask President Kaufman and Provost Fournier to come forward. President Kaufman, I invest in you the authority to confer degrees. Provost Fournier will now present the candidates.
Will the candidates for the bachelor's degree please rise and remain standing? President Kaufman, on behalf of the faculty of the college, it is my privilege to present the candidates for the degrees of Bachelor's of Arts, Bachelor of Music, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, and Bachelor of Social Work.
Upon the recommendation of the faculty, and by the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, I now confer upon each of you the recommended bachelor's degree with all the rights and privileges, as well as all obligations and responsibilities. Congratulations, graduating class of 2023.
The candidates will be introduced by Sharon Croft, Professor of Communication, and assisted by Dr. Terry Lam, Senior Associate Provost. Candidates for bachelor's degrees will receive their diploma from Dr. Fournier and President Kaufman. They will now greet the graduates and present their diplomas.
Kwame Amako. Michael Baylor Aperis, magna cum laude. Luke Atkins, summa cum laude. Luke Ballinger. Sasmita Bastula. Kaylee Beach. Ava Bernhardt, summa cum laude. Brandon Black, magna cum laude. Kyler Block. Jack Blosser, magna cum laude. Ava Baldazar, magna cum laude. Abigail Bradford, summa cum laude. Grace Brannon, summa cum laude. Demi Brewer. Aaliyah Reltick, summa cum laude. Jonathan Dale Brown, the second. Zach Brown. Gabe Bick, magna cum laude. Derek Byron. Jessica Camp, cum laude. Kevin Capron, cum laude. Abby Casto, cum laude. Dario Sanko. Cameron Serrato. Curtis Clark. AJ Cleveland. His diploma is being presented by his father, Sean Cleveland, Director of the Regional Development for Capitals Law School. Tiana Collins. Sydney Crothers. Ryan Crowley, cum laude. Lauren Cubberly, summa cum laude. Kaylee Cyphers. Vince Starr, cum laude. Mackenzie Davis, summa cum laude. Ava DeFawcett. Hope DeVold. Alicia Dickinson. Jake Diley, magna cum laude. Angelo Donato, summa cum laude. Mike Dunlop. Nate Fikes. Allison Ford. Allison Fouts, summa cum laude. Evan Frund. Gage Garlinghouse, summa cum laude. Abby Gishel. Keandra Graves, magna cum laude. Sarah Griffin. Shelby Griffith. McKenna Gugold. Molly Haley, summa cum laude. Tracy Han, cum laude. Ailey Harden. Addie Hasselbach. Lincoln Hayes. Jalen Haynes, magna cum laude. Camden Heater. Joshua Heinzelman, summa cum laude. Jeremy Hill. Louis Hurston. Matthew Hollis, cum laude. Madeline Horsley, summa cum laude. Jane Host. Alexis Howard, magna cum laude. James Howenstein. Nicholas Hong. Olivia Humes, cum laude. Madison Hurley, summa cum laude. Hines. Tate Isley. Robert Jesse. Reagan Johnson, magna cum laude. Aaliyah Jones. Evan Casing. Chris Conkey, magna cum laude. Brandon Carl, cum laude. Garrett Kennedy, summa cum laude. Ryan Kerman. Summer King, magna cum laude. Mac Knaus, cum laude. Spencer Knight, magna cum laude. Ved Coley, magna cum laude. Clara Kroll, summa cum laude. Joshua Kuntz. Trinity Langbein, summa cum laude. Haley Lathy, summa cum laude. Gabby Ledbetter. Jelena Lee. Max Lee. Lexi Leggett, magna cum laude. Jake Lewis. Erica Linder. Tommy Lipp. Ethan McDonald. Camden Martin, cum laude. Paul Martinez Watkins, magna cum laude. Lance Matthews. Michael McBeth. Miles McBride. Justin McClelland, magna cum laude. Sydney McCreary, summa cum laude. Cullen J. McCulley. Madison McInnes, magna cum laude. Trey Meister. Evan Mendez. Kayla Metzger. Claire Mitchell, cum laude. Isabel Morbitzer, summa cum laude. Casey Moreland, summa cum laude. Peyton Moyer, summa cum laude. Katia Maria Riaz, summa cum laude. Shane Murphy, summa cum laude. Ethan Neal, cum laude. Kama Neff, magna cum laude. Eric Noble. Aaron Norman, summa cum laude. Aaron Olick. Jacob Pelliquin. Kent Peterson, cum laude. Mira Pudel. Ethan Price. Kyla Primer, cum laude. Sean Rankin, summa cum laude. Aiden Riemann. Logan Robbins, summa cum laude. Christopher Rockwell II. Natalie Rogers, cum laude. Anna Root. Lauren Rose, magna cum laude. Alex Roschert, cum laude. His diploma is presented by his aunt, Terry Meng, maintenance technician in facilities management. Olivia Rotolo. Cheyenne Salters. Elijah Santana. Brayton Schmidt. Destiny Schultz, magna cum laude. Taylor Schultz. Tabitha Shelton, cum laude. Alexa Shields. Jack Shoemaker. Taylor Short, summa cum laude. Andrew Simpson. Camille Simpson, summa cum laude. Tyler Slusher. Dylan Smith, cum laude. Hannah Smith, summa cum laude. Shane Smith. Cornelio Soto. Alex Sperry, summa cum laude. Kayla Stein, cum laude. Liz Stonerock, summa cum laude. Caleb Thompson. Aubrey Tillman, summa cum laude. Kiara Tyus. Caroline Urbanek. Nick Valdez. Gavin Van Horn. Stephen Vance, summa cum laude. Paige Vanderhoff, cum laude. Woo! Tessa Vara, magna cum laude. Charles Waldvogel. Samuel Wallace, cum laude. Cassie Wolf, cum laude. Kent Wolford. Madeline Woodruff, summa cum laude. Alex Wyatt. Guillermo Zarati. His diploma is presented by his father, Sergeant Guillermo Zarati, an officer of Capitol's Public Safety Department. Madeline Zizzuto, cum laude. Tiffany Zulski, summa cum laude. Anna Allman, magna cum laude. Roxolana Antoniuk, summa cum laude. Olivia Carruthers, cum laude. Yuchi Chin. Anthony Drake. Reagan Dunlop, summa cum laude. Elise Hancock Phillips, cum laude. Theo Hauser, summa cum laude. Brandon Ising, summa cum laude. Matt Miller. Emma Peterson, summa cum laude. Patrick Richards, summa cum laude. Hadia Taubau, cum laude. Brooke Barrington. Bora Bejko, cum laude. Madeline Berry, summa cum laude. Lauren Bowe, summa cum laude. Madison Campbell, magna cum laude. Jenna Chimlick, magna cum laude. Kathleen Cooley. Olivia Costello. Damascus Cummings. Antoinette Darby, cum laude. Deanna Driscoll. Gracie Fannin. Reagan Galagos. Kaylee Gould. Tori Green. Marley Joe Haynes. Alex Heyman. Emily Hemman, magna cum laude. Catherine Host. Caleb Hughes. Gabrielle Huster, magna cum laude. Brenna Jackson, cum laude. Samantha Kearns. Adil Khan. Jessica Kim, cum laude. Tessa Pilatus, cum laude. Dylan Lingerack, cum laude. Barrett Littman, magna cum laude. Bailey Myers. Caitlin Nagel, magna cum laude. Emily Niswander, cum laude. Shiamaku Okafor. Sophia Passerino, cum laude. Lizzie Perro, summa cum laude. Casey King, summa cum laude. Catherine Qualls, cum laude. Brianna Rampe, cum laude. Delaney Reynolds. Casey Robertson. Kelly Rodriguez. Mackenzie Russell. Monica Rushton. Brianna Shear. Veronica Shinosky. Brenna Shope, magna cum laude. Ikran Talil. Alexandria Turner, cum laude. Sabina Apredi. Viviana Walls, magna cum laude. Kristen Ward, summa cum laude. Ebenezer Yeboah. Hannah Carter. Courtney DiGiorgi, summa cum laude. Suad Gira, magna cum laude. Bobby Khan, cum laude. Henrietta Richardson. Jennifer Tenenbaum. Iman Garba Zakari. Zhanyang Zhou, magna cum laude, is unable to be here as his wife is pregnant and they are unable to travel. They are watching from St. Louis. Skyla Cato, magna cum laude. Haley McPhillips. Skyla and Haley are unable to be here today. They are competing in the first round of the NCAA Women's Lacrosse Tournament later today in Lexington, Virginia.
The commencement ceremony will continue when the last graduate leaves the photo area and returns to their seat. Thank you. Please welcome Dr. Jody Fournier back to the podium.
It is now time to observe a commencement tradition for new alumni. Graduates, please rise. To signify your graduation, please move the tassel on your mortarboard from right to left. Also, graduates, let's recognize those who helped reach you and who helped you reach this important milestone. Please turn and applaud your families, friends, and loved ones, and show your appreciation for their support. Everyone, please rise and join us for the singing of the alma mater. Please be seated. And now we observe one final important rite of passage. Graduates, you will recall your very first days on campus when our academic community was called together to welcome you as first-year students to Capital University. You celebrated with your family members as you processed through Memorial Gateway to begin your studies. But as you know, Capital's tradition prevented you from exiting the gate until graduation. Now we're going to complete this tradition by again calling our community together to applaud your success and your promise as you mark the completion of your academic journey by walking out Memorial Gateway. So following the benediction and recessional, we'll see you at the gate.
Will be given by Reverend Drew Tucker, University Pastor. Please stand for the benediction.
While an invocation addresses God and invites God's presence, a benediction addresses people. In class of 2023, this benediction is for you. You do not know yet what the times of the future hold, dear ones, but trust this. You are called to such times as these. There is something sacred within you, and it yearns for you and us all to flourish. Just as your lives have been transformed, the transformation is not yet complete. We commission you now to go forth to transform new people, new communities, with the gifts and challenges and growth that you have experienced here. Share the divine image that is within you, and remember that that truly divine thing changes all things for the good. So as you depart, we deploy you to be conspirators for the common good. Wherever you go, whatever you do, give all you meet the light they need, the warmth they need, the energy they need, because class of 2023, I know you can do it, because God is with you and I have seen you shine with radiant splendor. And all the people said, amen.
Please be seated for the academic recessional.
Thank you.
A reminder for family members and guests. We ask you to make your way quickly to the memorial gate so that you'll be ready to applaud the graduates as they exit through the gate. Please exit out the doors at the back of the auditorium. Again, please exit out the doors at the back of the auditorium to quickly line the walkways leading to Memorial Gate and Main Street. Proceed under the Learning Center bridge to the walkways leading toward the Blackmore Library. Directions are also printed in your program. Thank you.